Pranam everyone. Today I will take your problems which you have asked from the test paper and from the shares and dividend. Now let's begin with the test paper first. Question number 3. In question number 3, principal monthly installment is given to you, Rs. 200. Rate of interest is 10%. Maturity value is 6775 and we have to find out the number of installment. As I told you, that the formula for the maturity value is NP plus I. But I is also not given and N is not given. So what we will do, we will substitute the value of I also here. Formula for the I, P into N, N plus 1 into R upon 2 into 12 into 100. Now substitute the values. Maturity value is 6775. Number of installment we don't know. And the monthly installment is 200 here. Again, 200, n, n plus 1, r is 10, upon 2 into 12 into 100. Simplify this term. These two zero will get cancelled from these two zero. 2 will get cancelled. 2 5s are 10, 2 6s are 12. It means it will be now 200 n plus n, n plus 1 into 5 upon 6. Now what we will do, we will take the LCM. LCM of these two numbers is 6 now. It will be 1200n plus 5n square plus 5n. And here 6775. Cross multiply this term, we will get a quadratic equation here. And the quadratic equation will be now, it will be 5n square plus 1205n. And minus, it will be now, just multiply this term by this, it will be 6 5s are 30, carry 3, 42, 45, carry 4, 42, 46, 4, 36 and 40, 4 0, 6 5 0. Right, now you know that 5 is common here, we will divide this entire term to make this simplified form of our equation here. So we will divide it by 5 and after dividing we will get the equation n square plus 5 2s are 10, 5 4 1, 4 241 n minus 5 8s are 40, 5 1s are 5, 1 5 are 15, 0 and this one. Is it okay? Now this is the quadratic equation. Final quadratic equation is n square plus 241 n minus 8130 equals to 0. Now we will make the factors of 8, 1, 3, 0. Make the factors is 2, 4, 2, 6 are 12, 2, 5. Then again 3, 1, 3, 3 are 9, 3, 5 are 15, 3, 5 are 15. Again 5, it's 5, 2s are 10, 5, 7s are 35, 5, 1s are 5. Now further, we cannot simplify this one term. It's a prime number now. Now it will be n square plus 271n minus 30n minus 8130 equals to 0. Take n common, n plus 271 minus 30 common, n plus 271 equals to 0. So in one bracket we are getting n minus 30 and n plus 271 equals to 0. The value of n is coming 30 and here n is minus 271. So this we will not take because it is a negative and number of months will never be in negative. So 30 number of installment is coming. Suppose if I have to convert into the years, it will divide by 12, 2, 6, 15, 3, 2, 3, 5. So it will be 2 whole 1 by 2 years. So our answer is time is equals to 2 whole 1 by 2 years. Is it clear how to solve this type of a question when the number of installment we have to find out? Okay, now from the shares and dividend, you ask question number 5th. In that question, just read the question properly first. What is given to you, write that first. Now, number of share is given to you 50, nominal value is 100, market value is 130, dividend 7.5% and annual income is given 150 and we have to find out the extra shares and annual income. Now, annual income, you know, the formula for the annual income, first part, annual income is D percent into nominal value into number of shares. Now, substitute the value first of all. 7.5% is given, 7.5 by 100 into nominal value is 100 and the number of shares is given to you 50 here. This 0, 100 will get cancelled from this 100. Now multiply this term. So you will get 0, 25 to 37. It means 375 rupees. 375 rupees is the annual income. Now the question is that we have to find out how many number of extra shares you will buy from the income 150. So what we will do, we will write the formula again here. Annual income is equals to D percent into nominal value into number of shares. Now extra shares we have to find out. Here it increases to 150 now. Dividend percent 7.5% upon 100. Nominal value is 100. And number of shares we have to find out. So this will get cancelled. So the number of shares will be now 150 by 7.5. This will get cancelled. 15, 5s are and 5, 2s are 0 and 20. So the extra shares will be now 20. How many extra shares you will purchase now? 20 extra shares. So that the income increases to 150. Is it clear? So in this way we have to solve question number 5th. Now you have a query in question number 24th. Now question number 24th and 34th, there is a little bit difference in that question, ki that sale proceed word is there. Now first of all, what is sale proceed? That I will explain you and then I will solve that question. Now sale proceed it itself for investment. Now how it will be investment now? Now suppose if a person purchased a share from one company and then he sold all those shares and invest whatever the amount he get, he invest in the another company. So the amount, the investment, that investment which he invested on the another company is called the sale proceed. For example, suppose in question number 24, the investment of the first company is given to you. This is question number 24. Investment is rupees 10080, right? Dividend is given to you 6% and nominal value is rupees 100 and market value is given to you 112. Now in this question, first of all, what we will do, we will take out the number of shares because the number of shares is not given, investment is given, dividend given, nominal value, market value given. So first step is, first we will find out the number of shares. Number of shares of this company is 112. Divide this term, you will get 90. If you will divide this one term, 90 number of shares we will get. Now 90 shares, now the question is that the share he sold for rupees 96, it means the share price means falls to the 96, it means the sale proceed. Now sale proceed will be what? Means he is investing now for the another company. It will be 90 into 96, whatever the number of installment for the first company. You will multiply it by the price which losses, means which falls down. So it will be now 19 to 96, it will be rupees 8640. This is called the sale proceed. Now this is the investment for the another company which is given in the question, that the nominal value for that company is rupees 5 and dividend for the another company is rupee is 10%. And market value is rupees 8. Right. Now it means how much number of shares he purchased for the another company will be. Number of shares will be now investment upon market value of one share. That is 8640 divided by market value is 8. It means if you will solve this one, 1080 are the number of shares for the second company. Right. Now the question is, you have to find out the change in the annual income. Means how much there is a change in the annual income for the first company and for the second company. Now we will take out the income first. It will be again the formula is same. D percent into nominal value into number of shares. Put the value, dividend is 6% here. Nominal value is 100 and the number of shares for this company is 90. So if we'll cancel, rupees 540 is coming. How much is coming? 540. Now similarly, we'll take out the second company interest, that is I2. It will be again D percent into nominal value into number of shares. So D percent here 10. So 10 by 100 into nominal value is 5 rupees and the number of shares is 1080. If we will simplify this term, again you will get 8 5s of 40, carry 4 and 5, 540. So, for the first company income is 540, second company income is 540, it means there is no change. So, they are asking for the change, so no change, same annual income is coming. So, answers for both the company is 540. Is it clear or not? So, this is known as the sale proceed, and in this way we have to solve this question. Okay, now you have asked one more question, that is 34th question number. Question number 34, that is also a sale proceed question that I will tell you now again. In question number 34, what is given to you? First of all, write that. Question number 34, market value is given to you rupees 77 and the dividend is 2 whole 1/4% and nominal value is 100 rupees. Now, and for the another company, they said the nominal value is rupees 100, market value 110 and dividend is 6%. Dividend is 6%. Now see, the number of shares is not given, investment is not given in this question. So what we will do, we will write, let the number of shares for the first company will be X. Because number of shares are not given to you, so the number of shares will be X. Now we will take out the income. Annual income for the first company will be now D percent into nominal value into number of shares. Now D percent is 2 whole 1/4, it means 9/4, percent means upon 100, nominal value is 100 and number of shares is X. If you will cancel this one, it will be 9/4 of X is coming for the first company. Right, now the question is that, now what will be the sale proceed now for the another company? See, sale proceed here, number of shares X and the market value is 77, it means the sale proceed will be 77X. Because we know the formula that number of shares into market value of one share. So this will be the sale proceed. And this sale proceed is the investment for the second company. So the investment is 77X. Right. Now we will take out the number of shares for the second company will be investment upon market value of one share. That is 77X upon 110. This is the number of shares. If we will simplify this one, 11 7s are 77 11, so it means 7/10 of X. So this is the number of shares. Now we will take out the second income for the company. It means D percent into nominal value into number of shares. D percent is 6/100, nominal value is given to you here 100 and the number of shares is 7/10 of X. This will get cancelled. 2 3s are 2 5s are, it means 21/5X. This is the I2. Now in the question it's given that the income increases by 117. What does it mean? That the first income, whatever the income we are getting, now it increases to 117. Write the relation first. Substitute the value. It will be 9/4 of X, 117, and I2 is 21/5 of X. Now shift these term here, simplify this one, LCM will be 20 now, it will be 484 minus 45 x and 117. If you will solve it, you will get 117 into 20 equals to, if you will subtract this one, it will be coming 9 and 3, 39 x. So the x will be 117 into 20 by 39. If you will divide this one term, it will be coming now, this will be coming 3 and 60. It means the number of shares which we have taken as x, the number of shares will be 60 now. How many number of shares? 60. Is this clear to all of you or not? How to find out? Main thing is just read the question properly and then write what is given to you and what we have to find out. Thank you, and if any query, let me know.